Hi guys. So in this video, I'm going to discuss the use of oral corticosteroids and how they can be detrimental for your Achilles tendons recovery process. So to give you a bit of background, we've got an online physiotherapy clinic where we treat patients from all over the world for Achilles tendon injuries. And we've been seeing more and more patients who get put on oral corticosteroids, so tablets that you swallow, when they have tendon pain. So in this video, I'm going to explain to you why that's really not good for your tendon and how it can actually delay your healing response. I'm also going to talk about why do doctors then prescribe it if it's not good for you. And then lastly, I'm going to talk about if you are on them, how you can safely come off them, because it's really important not to go cold turkey and just stop taking them. That can actually damage your body. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Maryke. I'm one of the physiotherapists from treatmyachilles.com, where you can get online physiotherapy assessment as well as treatment for your Achilles injuries. Have a look at the description of this video if you want a link to our website. Okay, so what's the deal with corticosteroid? Now, it's been known for years and years and years that steroid injections in and around the Achilles tendon can have really detrimental effects. Despite that fact, people still use it, but luckily not as often anymore. So if you need any proof of that, there's a recent research review article from 2013 where Dean and colleagues looked at all the research around Achilles tendons and the use of corticosteroid injections in and around the tendon. And what they found was that the study showed that you get a loss of collagen organization. So that means, remember, tendons are mainly made up of collagen fibers and they are all packed in nice parallel lines. And that's what makes it so strong, so that they're really tough structures. But then after you've had a steroid injection, that messes up the structure of the collagen. Now, you may wonder why I'm talking about injections when it's actually about oral steroids that we're going to talk, but you'll understand in a minute. So then another thing that they found from looking at all the research available in the world is that it increases collagen necrosis. So necrosis is when cells die. So if you get a corticosteroid injection or a steroids, you get different types of steroids as well that they can put in there. It actually increases how many cells die off in your tendon. And you can see why that's not useful if you actually have a tendon injury. Also, the viability and the proliferation of fibroblasts. So what does that mean? Fibroblasts are the little cells who create healthy tendon tissue. And the proliferation means how many of them are created. So that's decreased when you have a steroid injection. Also, collagen synthesis decreased. So you're just not producing as many fibers and new fibers. So again, when we think of Achilles tendinopathy specifically, where you need to be creating new collagen fibers, really not a useful thing to have. And then lastly, it also increased cellular toxicity, which means that the cells become, it's a toxic environment. So again, it increases how many of them will die off or become injured. Now, that's injections. So is there any research around oral tablets? Well, there's a article that was done by Spoendlin and colleagues in 2015. And this study was written up in 2015, but it stretched over the previous several years. And what they found was that people who took oral steroids were at a much higher risk of having a tendon tear of either the biceps tendon. They looked specifically at bicep tendons and Achilles tendons. Also, what they found was it's dose dependent, and that even just one high dose of steroids put you at a higher risk. So it's not just steroids injected around the tendon, it's also steroids that you swallow. And that makes sense, because if you think about it, the reason for swallowing those tablets is that it goes through the body and it gets to where it needs to be. So it doesn't matter if you inject it or take it orally, it's going to get to the tendon eventually. Only thing with taking it orally is it also gets to all your other tendons. So you may even get more side effects from it. Then a recent study, it was G and colleagues, and it's a 2020 study that's just come out. And what they did was they wanted to see, they looked at two things. They looked at humans and they looked at rats. And for the humans, they took humans who had ruptured their Achilles tendons and they divided them into groups two groups. They looked at the ones who had taken oral steroids over a period of time versus a group who hadn't taken that. And when they had the surgery to repair the tendons, they took a little bit of that tendon and just looked at it under a microscope. And what they found was that the guys who had taken oral steroids had tendon tissue that was more irregular and was more degraded than the guys who hadn't taken steroids for a period of time before that. So then also what they looked at was with rats, they injected them with steroids, and 5 weeks later what they found was that the rat's tendons who had the steroids had thinner tendons and they weren't as strong as the other ones. So that just supports the fact that it doesn't matter if it's oral steroids or injections, it still negatively affects your collagen turnover. To be honest, if it's going to be oral, it's going to be the whole body. Now, if it's this bad for you, why do doctors still prescribe it? I've got a theory that it is because it works so well as a painkiller. So if you look at the research around tendinopathies and steroid use, there is no argument that for the first 5 weeks after the steroid injection, patients who's had the injection has much lower pain levels. But that turns around. After 5 weeks, they have similar pain levels to the guys who didn't have the injections. And there's research from tennis elbows that actually, a few years later, the guys who had the steroids is in a worse place than the guys who didn't have it. And if we think of how steroids affect collagen, that kind of makes sense. Now, so doctors use it mainly because it's so good at calming pain down. And my problem with that is that pain is not the injury here. Pain is a symptom. So yeah, fine, you shut the pain up. Patient's happy because the patient doesn't have pain now. But what are you doing to the healing process? You're not helping it at all. In fact, you're actually maybe delaying the healing process and making it harder for that tendon to respond to strength training later. Because remember, if you've got an injury to your Achilles tendon, the idea is to actually get it to calm down through things like wearing shoes with heels on it, that it's a little bit lifted, offloaded, taking away the most aggravating things, so cutting your activity down a little bit. So you just let it to calm down, and then you've got to strengthen it up because that tendon's too weak for what you want to be doing. But you're not going to get it stronger by just resting it. Remember, I mean, anybody can identify with the fact that if you just lie on the couch, you lose all your muscle tone eventually and everything becomes flabby. And it's not just your muscles that react that way, it's your tendons as well. So yes, fine, it's brilliant, you're pain-free after corticosteroids, but in the long term, that's really not useful. So then if we look at what if you've actually been put on steroids and you've been taking tablets orally for your tendon problem, what should you do? Now remember, steroids is a normal thing. It's a normal substance that you have in your body yourself. It's something that your body produces on a regular basis. Now, when you take tablets to increase the levels of that, your body goes, oh, there's plenty of that. I can detect it in the blood, so I don't have to produce so much. So it starts decreasing its production. Now, if you just go cold turkey and you take all of the tablets away, it's a pretty big shock to the body and it may not catch up immediately. So you may get really ill from that. So the better way to do that, and that's why if you've been prescribed it, you probably would have been told by your doctor that you have to build up to a certain level, keep it there, and then slowly decrease it again. And that slow decrease is so that the body can go, oh, wait a second, we need more of this stuff. I need to start producing more. So it's basically to get your body to produce its own again. So make sure if you don't want to be taking steroids anymore, chat to your doctor that you can have a safe way of coming off it, because you can't just go cold turkey on it. Great. So let me know if you've got any questions. And remember, if you need more help with your Achilles injury, you're welcome to consult one of us via video call. The link to our website is in the description of this video. Take care.